This segment will show you how to determine the net present value of a series of cash flows. In this example, we have a series of cash flows starting at the beginning of period 1, which we call period 0, with an outflow of 20,000, and then the next 5 years we have inflows of cash. We would like to determine what the net present value is of this series of cash flows. In order to do this, we can make use of the net present value function. So if we click on the cell and go to the function wizard, go into the financial categories and find the NPV function. This will appear. We're asked to fill it in. The first criteria is to give it a rate, which is a rate of discount over the length of one period. And in this case, it's this cell here. We now need to enter the values. And if you click on the first one, you'll see that it tells you here it's value 1, 2, all the way up to 29 of income, equally spaced in time and occurring at the end of each period. Now, this is very, very important because if you look at our numbers, period 0 is actually the beginning of period 1, and then period 1, that's the end, the end, the end. If we assume the values are all these cells, we will be incorrect because Excel will assume that this 20,000 investment actually occurs at the end of period 1. So in order to do this, our value 1, we highlight all cash flows that happen at the end of the period. And when we push OK, you'll see we get a net present value. However, we have to be very careful because what we've told to do is give us the net present value of all the cash flows at the end of the years. We have excluded this. Now, because it happens at the beginning of period 1, we don't have to worry about present valuing it because the number is already present valued. So in order to get an accurate net present value, you need to subtract the initial investment. So you'll see we've got a cell here for initial investment. Make that equal to the beginning period. When you push enter, you'll see I've summed these two. So the net present value of this series of cash flows is actually this number here.